Hello everybody and welcome back to another edition of Let's Play Pokemon Yellow. Okay, now I can keep going down this way. I think we did see a little bit of this, so I can catch that Mankey way back in the first video where my stupidity began. And here we go. Jerk fight. What? Yellow? What a surprise to see you here. So you're gonna go to the Pokemon League? You collected all the badges too? That's cool. Then I'll whip you, Yellow, as a warm-up for the Pokemon League. Come on! Yeah, whatever. Okay, our last jerk fight. Okay, good. I got the right Pokemon out first. I can't help but feeling like, I don't know, it's weird being this underleveled. I don't know, Jerk usually is a few levels above me, but not this much. Execute, that is a grass type. Get Triple M out, Fire Blast him. Glad I have Fire Blast. I don't remember what Eeveelution he chose. I think it was Jolteon, I don't remember. But either way. Clayster, so we're gonna get Larry out. It's nice having a six Pokemon fight, you know. And if you get the right guess in the first one, pretty much one when it comes to Jerk. Thunderbolt. And we're equally level too, wow. You have the right Pokemon and the right moves, you know? It's all you need. Okay, Magneton. Let's get Bolin out. I guess Jerk doesn't have his Alakazam. Alakazam was always the hardest part about... Always the hardest part about that this fight. These Jerk fights. Let's just call them Rival Fights. That's what they're actually called. But in my case, it's Jerk Fight anyway. But yeah, like, point is, hang on, one more. Should do it. There we go. Maybe he does have the psychic type and he was smart enough not to bring it out yet. I don't know. Okay, could. Yeah, here it is. Yeah. Darn it. Okay, let's... I'm gonna get Larry out first. Yeah. I think that's the best fit. Bet. Not fet. I was gonna say fit. Then I said bet. Came out as fet. I think a thunder is a good idea. Oh, actually hit for me. Awesome. Of course. Yeah, his Kadabra is always the toughest part of the fight. But you know, it's like... It's good to get comfortable fighting your rival, and it's good that it is, especially since you have to face Elite Four first. If you're like, you spoiled it, you know, I don't care. I'm just saying, I don't care. Of course that happens. He's my strongest Pokemon. Let's get Bolin back out, I guess. This is gonna be the hardest part of the fight. Earthquake might work. Come on, survive. You will survive. Okay, good. I hate recover so much. I'm just gonna use it 1,000 times over. Unless he dies, yes. Okay, Bolin needs that level up. It's been a long time for him. And then Flareon. Yes, he got a Flareon on Jolteon. Oh, it's like fighting an old buddy. We had a Flareon. Remember? Twins? That was our old Flareon. Oh, now you get to see the front sprite. And Flareon should be dead this one shot. This is excellent practice, though, for Elite Four. Oh, what? Surprisingly not. Probably because he's 12 levels above me, but, you know, no big deal. So you want to know a cool trick? You can actually beat a... you actually beat the Dragonite in this game with a level 3, Pidgey or either Pidgey or Rattata or Zubat. Let's do with the AI. Tyler's trying to learn Skull Bash. I'm going to replace Bite with that. I've been with Bite for so long. But normally I keep Bite in future gens because it counts as a dark type move, but it's a normal type move here. And I defeat a jerk. What? I was just careless. Yeah, and I got a lot of money. That loosened me up. I'm ready for the Pokemon League. Yellow, you need more practice. But I beat you. But hey, you know that. I'm out of here. Smell ya. I hate you. Alright, quick trip to the Pokemon Center, obviously. Okay. No, stupid not Super Nintendo controller. They couldn't let me have that convenience of the Super Nintendo controller, like, honestly. Alright, so now we're going to the Elite Four, which is going to annoy me to death. I hate Victory Road. I know I've made that very clear in the last playthrough, but I hate Victory Road. Up until, probably Gen 5. I mean, I never played Gen 4's Victory Road, but, Gen 5 had a great one, Gen 6 had a great one, and this one's... When I played Red, it wasn't as bad as I remember, but I still have those painful memories. I really should buy some repels. Oh well. We'll go in. We'll go in naked. Make things more interesting. Ugh, come on. You guys really want me to get repels, don't you? Talking to the game genies. We make the universe of games together. Okay, let me go down here. No, that's not what I wanted. Yeah, that's a trap. So I gotta be very careful with my steps. Because now I gotta start this over again. Really obnoxious. There we go. Pokemon League Front Gate. Now, you can show this early, which I like. You know, it shows you the future, what you can do. But I always just not show it off till the end. Okay, yeah. So now we're going to... And this is cool, too, this little walk. You know, show that you're worthy and all. And there's some patches of grass here and some water coming up. That's your last opportunity to grind and your last opportunity to catch anything. Just so you know. I like how they play the evolution music here, too, on the way. It's really nice use of music, you know, save space in the cartridge and whatnot. Thank you. Okay. You know what would be interesting? I'm sure it's on YouTube. Ah, darn it. What am I doing? I'm sure it's on YouTube. I'm just going to surf all day. I'm sure it's on YouTube, but I would love, actually love to see if somebody glitched their way through through Victory Road and see what happens. Probably won't be the most interesting in the world, but it would still be cool. Oh, you know what I learned recently that's really cool? Apparently in this game, there was never a fix, in the Japanese versions of Gen 1, if you... You can actually make the game unbeatable if you overlevel a Pokemon in a certain part of the game. Like, you can't continue if you do that. Something like that. It's really cool. I mean, who would do that anyway? Overlevel the Pokemon to, like, level 50 or something when you're in Vermillion? It's like, that'll take probably months. It's like the episode of South Park with the World of Warcraft episode. That was a great one. But that's, like, the perfect example right there. Okay, here we are, Victory Road. Not looking forward to this. Strength puzzles galore. Oh yeah, I remember this. Might as well activate it here. Oh yeah, I remember what to do. Here we go. Zubat galore. You know, I do have half a mind just to go back and get, repels. Who knows? What am I doing? Oh, yeah, that's what I'm doing. Ugh. Can't wait to get out of this. And I do have to admit, the wild Pokemon, other than Zubat, are really good grinding opportunities, if you guys want to do that. That's just some of my advice. You can take it or leave it. Strength puzzles. Who needs them? And it'd be a lot less annoying if the trainer can just naturally do this, but no, you need to use strength every time. Again, improve in the future installments, but you know. I'm probably gonna battle every trainer I can find here. If anything, Victory Road will probably be a two-parter with the way I want to do it. I should get Tyler out of the front. I'm gonna do that. Pokemons. Yeah, Nick needs some training. At the very least, I would like Nick and Triple M to be in the level 40s, in the 40s club. I don't know. And yes, I'm sure you noticed, I've pretty much given up cutting out wild encounters and battles at this point. We're almost done here. That's just my feelings on the matter. Okay, no, this is just an item thing. I'm not going to bother. You get Manamir all you want, but I bothered in Pokemon Red. Oh, boy. I said I'd battle him anyway. So how's everybody doing? Darn, I'll get to ask Pikachu how everybody's doing. Pikachu is the decider of how you guys are doing for me. I kind of wish I had that in every game. Boost my ego a little bit. Okay, it's been a long time since I fought with Nick here. Luckily, I'm good like that. Okay, this is gonna take forever. Believe it or not, I don't think Nick has the best moves in the world either here. He pretty much has all the typical moves a Bulbasaur would have in the anime. Well, Venusaur, I mean. Oh, man. Mega Drain, I should have done this a long time ago. Really long time ago. Don't kill me. Oh, nice. You rock, Nick. Come on. I really should have prepared more for this. I didn't prepare at all. Oh, I forgot about that. Okay, screw this. Larry. You've awakened the force of Larry. Come on. I can't believe this late in the game I have to do switch outs. Oh my god. Of course, if I did pick a Viridian path to Cinnabar, we probably would be in this mess. I am probably gonna do it off screen once I know I can fly to the Pokemon League. Perfect. Alright, oh, there's another one. This is a Ninetales, so let's go to Tyler again. So I feel bad because I've been ignoring Venusaur, which is a shame because Venusaur is my first Bulbasaur is the first Pokemon I ever had, period. You know, you think I'd... I mean, this is Pikachu's game, Pokemon Yellow. But yeah, you know. What are you gonna do, right? Past is the past. And you're dead. It's another thing I should have had. Repels too, but should have got some escape ropes. I know it's not too late to turn back, but I'm just gonna be stubborn. I'm sorry. Just want to be stubborn right now. Just let me be stubborn. No, wait. Oh, okay, good. Didn't get caught by his gaze. I mean, I should fight him, but still. Actually, you know what? Rock types. This is a good opportunity to train Nick more. You gotta be able to judge when or when not to attack or when or not to run away. It's a big part of that, you know. Darn it! I knew we couldn't get out of it. That was weird before, though. That never happened before when I got in a gaze at the same time I got a wild encounter. That's weird. And no one else is shocked that cool trainers have whips, right? I'm just throwing that out there. This Ivysaur is more powerful than I am. No, wait, no, I didn't want to do that. No, that's right. It better not affect me. Oh, this could be a long fight. At least the poison powder, which he'll keep trying to do, won't affect me. Good old Gen 1 AI. Good old Gen 1 AI. I'm taking advantage of that right now. Love this. I am loving this. Taking advantage. Taking advantage at night. Die, die, die. Okay, now he's going to use a hyper potion, which will annoy me. Oh, no. Surprisingly, no. Very good. Very happy about that. Goodbye. Oh, this is interesting. I wonder if this battle is going to have, this is interesting. If they have a Charmeleon, that'd be really cool. Ooh, an extra attack. How fancy. Yeah, all these trainers in here, and from now on, you know, also the Elite Four, also the everything else, they will have their own item on them. Okay, cool. And Charmeleon. Yeah, that's cool. Charmeleon, all right. Charmeleon. Okay. I like you better when you were Charmander. Look at another Charmander. Charmander! That took a toll on me. I shouldn't have done that. Oh, we're equal level, too. See, everyone should be at Tyler's path right now. But they're not. Oh, well. Oh, well. But yeah, this is a really cool trainer. I'm glad this is here. I don't remember if this was in red or not. Probably not, but it's still cool. And for some reason, it has a Charizard after all that. And we're obviously going to surf to get rid of him. Oh, yeah, Slash, too. My Charizard is Slash as well. We are friends now. Because you have a cool team. You want to be a dick? Get him up. Hey, Blastoise, get him at the tail. See, I'm a dick, because that will kill him. And that ain't right. Oh, he knows Rage, too. All right. Bye. Good thing I self-revise on me. That's going to be really handy. Well deserved. Okay, next level. First time I've seen Golbat was really much better sprite here than the old one, but still creepy design. Okay, and since I'm in a new floor, yep, gotta reactivate strength. It's weird, I don't screw up strength, I don't screw up cut, I just always screw up, the other one. Ah, stupid controller. Alright. Really gotta get another Super Nintendo controller, for the... Because I love using it on the Retron 5. I don't know what happened. I gotta test this out on a regular Super Nintendo. See if it's not the controller input. Like, as much as I love what this thing can do, it does feel kind of cheaply made. I should have fought him. Oh, darn it! I said I'd fight them anyway. There's Moltres, by the way. But we don't care about that, right? Yes, we do. Shut up. Voice in my head that I now just invented. And now it's probably gonna haunt me in my YouTube channel for the rest of my days. Oh boy. Yo, what's up, dude? Show off your muscles. You know, that's vanity, Mr. Machoke. Nice. Got a good old-fashioned crit. Loved exploiting the AI back there. I wonder if I'm doing that. Sometimes you don't know if you're doing that again. Because a lot of times Pokemon will use Leer a few times that they know they don't have the strength to beat you. Very good. I really want Nick to be in the 40s club. The tough part is what I'm going to end up doing with Light Saga, because I really want to use Light Saga's Ice Beam to destroy the Dragon Trainer guy. You know what I'm talking about. But yeah, like that's a good thing. I feel like it's a good thing I do have Sing. Like, that'll definitely help me out a ton. And you're gone. Goodbye. Okay, we got Machoke. Okay, another one of these guys. Razor Leaf's not that powerful for Murray, but we'll see. If anything... Oh, wow, look at that. Got a nice crit. I love that. I love when this game actually wants to work out for me. Curiously, I actually might do another playthrough of this again. Not on YouTube, obviously, like on my own time. Because I really need to see if it was just the Let's Player's curse on me, because I can't believe I'm doing this bad in Gen 1. And like, if you guys are nervous if you always want to, if you, maybe your Pokemon Red or Blue cartridge died out, and you know, you want to see if, hang on. And you want to see if, like, you can, darn it. See if I get yellow instead, because I came out later, so it's more likely you get the battery to work on that. I definitely think it's much different. Not much different. It's a different experience. Just a different experience. Let's leave it at that. No, I don't know where to go from here. Well, we're by Moltres, so I can do that, but I'm not going to be honest with you. Of course, I said that like a million times. I think I made my point. Just steal that right next to you. Oh, don't stare at me like that, Pikachu. See, it's not bad when the Geodude does it, but when a Zubat does it, granted he's level 44, which is really good, but still annoys me. Okay. Here's a rock. Okay, no. Oh, darn it. Am I back at the beginning? Oh, no, wait, yeah. I think I know what to do next. I just want to look around a little bit to make sure. Yeah, there's that chick I fought before. Yes, okay. Darn it. So, yeah, there's your opportunity to get a Machoke if you want it. Okay, we're running pretty low on time. So, yeah, I kind of knew this would be a two-parter. Might have gone faster if I actually prepared for this, but I didn't. I'm really playing balls to the wall right now. But either way, this stuff would be a two-parter, so... When I end it, I'll end it. Even if I don't have a closer. Oh man, Machoke's like when it was black like that, scrolling to, you know, before they reveal what the Pokemon is, even though I know what it is. That sprite, oh, it looks so weird. Like, I think it's like, I don't know, I can't pinpoint what it looks like, but it's weird looking. Right, so this is an annoying one. This switch is gonna be annoying. Leave me alone. Leave me alone. Leave me alone. Thank you. Yeah, this is definitely the most annoying puzzle strength part right here. It's like, I can't blame the developers for doing it this way, because it makes sense. If I know you guys are like, no, you're stupid, but it does. It makes sense why they use strength, because it's the easiest way to make puzzles in this up-down perspective type of gameplay. At least for Pokemon standards. And they had other puzzles, like the rocket spin things and the whatnot, but... And the doors in Pokemon Mansion. Thankfully, these puzzles aren't so difficult for a kid to do. Yeah. Everyone has a different appeal of Pokemon. I don't think anybody has this as their appeal. I don't know, I'm just saying. That's right, pushing a rock around. Fear me and my strength. Yep. And you know, to this day, even with the better graphics, I was like, I don't see why they can't just have the Pokemon do actually push these around in the animation for strength, because like it makes it weird on what strength does, you know? It makes it unclear on what strength does. I don't know. I don't know if that's just me. That's just how I see it. Okay, and we've... Ah, I have a feeling I'm wasting my time. Who knows? I'm looking at the time right now, trying to remind myself to cut that part out. My dad was knocking on the door, and I had to let him know I was down here. Okay. So, did that actually do anything? There's Moltres. Should I go for it? Yeah, I guess it'll be a good end of the episode where I fail to catch it for some reason. Like in Pokemon Red. I'm not gonna try to catch it. I'm gonna throw Pokeballs at God, get rid of them. Actually, I think that rock was important to get Moltres. I don't remember. Moltres gets an awesome sprite here. Definitely gotta say that. Wrong Pokemon to have. My goodness, wrong Pokemon to have. If you're gonna face a Firebird, have a water type out. Of course, I get a crit. No! Come on! This thing haunted my dreams at Blaine. It's gonna haunt my dreams now. I'm just gonna mash. I'm sure you guys can hear these clickety clackety cheap buttons on this stupid controller I hate. Oh, come on. I hate this. I shouldn't have done this. I'm running out of hyper potions. And during a, honestly, during a fire spin, that is the best point to try to get yourself your bearings back. Since you're stuck in it, you might as well heal or revive or something. Right, this is good, good. No, go! Hate this. If I didn't hate that chipmunk voice I get, I'd probably fast forward through this. See, that's what got me through. That's what got me through Victor Oates so fast in Red, because I had to fast-forward things back then. And, I don't know, I still feel like I don't regret doing this live commentary, because I did post for Red. I probably should have done post for this game, but whatever. Alright. Item. Great Ball. Yeah, it still does that thing I hate. Alright, so screw that, I'm running away, I don't care. What? But it doesn't want to fight you. That's a story element in the game. I hate how it does that. It's so annoying how it does that thing where the Pokeball doesn't even try. Like, I do not remember that in the when I used to play this game, because I used to catch Moltres and Zapdos and Articuno all the time. I don't know. I mean, this was back when... Like, what the hell? How did I miss? Like, why do I miss Pokemon? It doesn't make any sense. Like, I'm thinking, like, is there something I have to do that? Oh, this is annoying the hell out of me right now. I shouldn't have done this. This is a huge mistake. Well, I mean, this is the only legendary bird you guys are going to see, so I might as well enjoy it, right? My pain that I'm going through right now with this stupid fire spin. Okay, you're dead. Goodbye. At the very least, bowling probably get a level up out of this. No, so I don't even get that. Goodbye. Jerks. Okay, where's my revives? Okay, I'll deal with healing them later. It's a waste of my time. Not fighting you. Actually, should I fight? Actually, should I go through there? I'm gonna try. Maybe you do have to face... Come to think of it, I think you do have to run into Moltres in the middle of this walk. And, you know, it's like, it's a good, thing, you know, of the Game Freak just think all of a sudden, like, yeah, you know what, let's put it here, you know, because, like, to try to go into the mind of the game developer, it's like, the Moltres was originally going to be a Mount Pyre, whatever, not Mount Pyre, that's in Gen 3, I'm thinking of that. I'm talking about the, when they added the Sevi Islands, Moltres was supposed to be on one of those mountains, but, they had to cut that part of the game out. So, due to time constraints, so like, you know what, let's put Moltres in Victory Road, you know what, and I can see why they'd think that, because the whole idea would be, that way, when you run into them, you'll think, oh, there must be more of these, let me explore a little more, and then you go to Seafoam, where you do see Articuno actually first, I think, but you don't always, so, oh god, I'm back here, so it was a complete waste of my time, great, just great. Wasted my time. Oh yeah, see you guys in the next one.